Previously, we talked in a couple other of our power hours and other training sessions about modern vehicles requiring a crank position relearn. After reprogramming the ECM or replacing it, after replacing the crank sensor, even after doing some transmission work, we made the statement that it's always recommended to do this. And we love getting feedback from our viewers. And a couple said, you know, that's a legacy thing. We did that with the old Vortec engines. Remember, you'd start it up, you put your foot on the brake, and you'd rev it up to the red line and do the relearn as it came back to idle. Well, I just want to share with you, we're in a 2023 Chevy Silverado here today. And if we look in the scan tool or even look in service information, that procedure is still required to be done on this particular vehicle. So I've already built the vehicle in the scan tool. And so as we look at my screen here, I'm going to go ahead and start the truck a second first. But I've already built the menu here. And if I click on special function, you can see we've got crank position variation learn. So I will select that. Same as what we've done in the past, tells us to put the transmission in park or neutral. Kind of interesting little side note on this new truck, you cannot shift out of park until you buckle up the seatbelt. I understand the safety aspect, but from a technician, it's terribly inconvenient when you're trying to move it just a couple feet here. So we're going to put the transmission in park or neutral, set the parking brake, and then block the drive wheels. That's already been done. I can select continue. Air conditioning is already off. Continue. And just like that, it's already done the test here. And so you can see that the learn status has passed because the conditions were satisfied. Now, earlier, if we would have not had the conditions satisfied, you would have seen something like the engine coolant temp display, the shift status, the engine RPM. It wants to make sure that all those conditions are met. Then it will force the relearn. But it's different from the ones in the past. We didn't have to really rev it up or anything like that. It identified top dead center and number one cylinder here all on its own at the idle position. So hopefully now you have a little better understanding. And just keep in mind, anytime you perform one of those services on a modern vehicle, it's still important to do a crank position relearn. Otherwise, your misfire counters might not be as accurate as what you'd like them to be.